The tourism sector in China reaping the benefits of relaxed COVID-19 restrictions. The domestic market is seeing steady growth, with both short and long distance travel posting a rebound in travelers. Among the choice destinations are ski resorts around Beijing and ice and snow festivals spurring travel demand. The China Tourism Academy notes the attitude of tourists has changed from cautious to optimistic as the country opened up for travel.
China warns of what it calls as countermeasures against the COVID testing requirements imposed by some countries on passengers traveling from China. Now, Beijing, however, did not offer details. The United States, Canada, Japan, and South Korea are just some of the countries that are enforcing testing protocols following the COVID outbreak in the mainland. Countries are also citing China's lack of transparency about its COVID data as a reason to test travelers. The surge in infections came in the heels of looser COVID restrictions.
Philippine President Marcos Jr. officially begins today his highly anticipated state visit to China. The trip comes amid lingering maritime tensions between the two countries and a spiraling COVID crisis in Beijing. Our correspondent Katrina Domingo now joins us live from China to tell us what's on the agenda for the president today. Good morning, Kat.
Hi, Mike. Good morning from Beijing. That's right. As you mentioned earlier, a full-packed agenda for President Ferdinand Marcos today. He is set to meet three key Chinese officials this morning to try to settle disputes in the West Philippine Sea, as well as to try to settle the deadlock between the Philippines and China when it comes to the joint oil and gas exploration projects that were set aside or shelved several months ago, just before former President Rodrigo Duterte came down or stepped out from office or ended his term as president. Mike, first on the president's agenda at 11 a.m., he is set to meet Li Shanchu, the chairman of China's National People's Congress, which is kind of similar to the Philippine Congress or the legislative body here in China. Next, President Marcos will be meeting Chinese Premier Li Keqiang, and third, President Marcos late in the afternoon will have dinner with President Xi Jinping. Three key issues that we are watching out for today is first, as I mentioned earlier, on whether or not the Philippines can finally settle the deadlock when it comes to the joint oil and gas exploration project in the West Philippine Sea. If we recall, way back in 2018, during the administration of former President Rodrigo Duterte, the Philippines and China signed an agreement that establishes a joint steering committee. But that did not prosper because two survey vessels, had to be pulled out from the West Philippine Sea due to alleged harassment from Chinese vessels. Now, we will see later on if President Marcos can finally close that deal, also given the constitutional deadlock that the Philippines and China have been bickering about. Also on the president's agenda on whether or not the Philippines and China can finally come up with a COC, a code of conduct on the South China Sea that will guide activities in the disputed waters. And third, Mike, we're also waiting for figures on how much the president can take home in terms of investment pledges. We see a lot of opportunities here for those in the nickel business, given that China imports 70% of its nickel requirement from the Philippines. China also promising to import more durian from the Philippines, so a lot of agricultural players also looking out for that news. Mike.
All right, thank you for that update, Katrina Domingo from Beijing.
Onto the air travel mess that hit the Philippines on New Year's Day. Former Philippine transport authorities asked current officials to stop passing the blame onto them. Ochi Tuazon, a former DOTR undersecretary, believes the incident which disrupted 282 flights due to a power shutdown was caused by negligence. Former transport chief Arthur Tugade also denies reports the 13 billion peso funding for the backup of air traffic control systems was allegedly diverted to the main gateway's cosmetic projects.